Hi, my name is Peter Zalewski. I'm the founder of CraneSpotters.com. CraneSpotters is a pre-construction condo project website that tracks new development in the Tri-County, South Florida region of Miami-Dade, Broward, Palm Beach counties. 2015, we've been doing regular updates of various markets in South Florida to give you, the viewer, an idea what's going on a real-time basis in these various markets. So for the week of December the 7th, we're going to be focusing on the greater downtown Miami condo market. One of the reasons we're doing this is that on December 19th, which is a Saturday, we're going to be doing one of our regular bus tours. We will fill up a bus and we'll basically spend about 3 hours driving through the streets of downtown Miami, showing you all the brand new condo towers that are slated to come down the pike. If you're interested in that, I'd encourage you to go to our website, CraneSpotters.com, or give us a call at 305-865-5859. That being said, let's get into the condo data. Let's start off with the pre-construction condo market. Currently today, 78 new condo towers and just over 23,000 units have been announced for greater downtown Miami. Now, when you look at this or you consider these numbers, it's important to keep in mind that there's four different phases of development. Typically, a development of a condo tower, it's going to take anywhere from 3 to 5 years to sort of bring together and make happen. So the way we break down the various condos is we put them into four phases. The first phase is proposed. This is a developer who wants to build but doesn't necessarily have approval yet to go forward and do so from the local municipality. So in that category today, roughly 34 new condo towers, just under 9,800 units, or roughly about 43% of the overall greater downtown Miami condo market is going to be in that proposed phase. Next category would be planned. Planned is when a developer wants to build and has obtained the approval to go ahead and do so. That currently stands at 13 new condo towers, and just under 4,700 units are in the planned phase, representing about 20% of the overall market. Next category or phase would be the under construction category, and that currently today represents 23 towers and just under 6,700 units, and or roughly about 29% of the marketplace. And then finally, you have the completed phase. Completed since 2011, we've had 8 towers and 1,900 units, or roughly about 8% of the overall marketplace. Now, when you look at greater downtown Miami, it's going to represent about 47% of all new condos slated to go up in South Florida east of I-95 during this cycle, which began in 2011. Now, if pre-construction isn't necessarily what you're interested in, but the resale condo market in greater downtown Miami is, let me give you some idea as to what's going on currently. So currently, there are just under 3,000 condo units on the resale market with an average asking price of about $500 a square foot in greater downtown Miami. Now, how does that asking price compare to real transaction price in the first 11 months of 2015? Well, there's about a 24% premium. So in currently they're asking $500 a foot, the sellers, but they're actually achieving an average price of $403 a foot. That $403 a foot in 2015 is flat to slightly down from 2014 during the same time when the average transaction price was $404. If you go back to the bottom of the last cycle, which would have been 2009, you would have found that the average transaction price was about $221 a foot. And if you would go to the peak of the last cycle, you'd find that the average transaction price was about $420 a foot. So what does all this mean? Well, what it means is today is year over year pricing in greater downtown Miami is flat to slightly down. Year over year, or pricing today is roughly 82% higher than the bottom of our last cycle, and that's ultimately about 4% lower than where we were at the peak of the last cycle. Now, what's going on in the transaction pace? Well, in the first 11 months of the year, there were just under 1,765 condos that traded on the resale market, representing about a 4% year-over-year drop. So that suggests that as pricing is going up, the number of transactions is actually going down. One final tidbit about the resale market I would point out to you. Currently, about 160 condos trade monthly in 2015 in the greater downtown Miami condo market. You divide that into available inventory, which is just under 3,000 units. You're going to come up with just under 19 months of available inventory. Typically, a balanced market is considered to have about 6 months. So this is really pushing towards a buyer advantage in theory in terms of what's going on in the resale marketplace. Now, the argument that's made is that the number of resales is increasing simply because so many people are buying into the pre-construction product, which is currently in the pipeline in the greater downtown Miami condo market area. Now, if you buy one of these condos and you want to turn around and try to rent it, let me give you some perspective of what's going on in the rental market. Currently, just under 1,650 properties are available for rent in greater downtown Miami at a median asking price of about $2.53 a square foot per month. This means that a 1,000 square foot apartment is basically going to go for just over $2,500 on an ask basis from the landlord. Now, what's that landlord actually achieving? First 11 months of the year, that landlord's achieved a median price of $243, or about $2,430. So there's only a 4% difference between the ask and the actual lease price. Now, how does 2015 pricing compare to 2014, year over year, first 11 months of each year? Well, it's up about 5%. If you would have leased the place in 2014, 2014, you would have paid a median price of $231 a foot, or roughly $2,300. You go back to 2013, median price was $214. And if we go all the way back to 2011, the oldest data for which is available currently, median price was $186 a foot. So we basically have gone for just under $1,900 a month for rent to currently today about $2,400, and the landlord's asking $2,500. So that's a fairly large price increase. But what I will tell you is, even though the price is going up, the number of transactions is also going up. So that's sort of an encouraging sign for landlords. In the first 11 months of the year, just under 2,860 properties were leased in greater downtown Miami, representing about a 3% year-over-year increase from 2014, when just under 5,700 units were leased in greater downtown Miami. And then finally, if you look at the greater downtown Miami rental market, you're gonna find that 533 properties are leased monthly, first 11 months of the year. Divide that into available inventory, we have about 3.1 months of supply. Again, a balanced market is about 6 months, so this is really a landlord's market still in greater downtown Miami. Going forward, I would point out that we have a number of rental properties that are currently under construction and could become in the market, so don't be surprised if we start to see a little bit of a shaking out or a weakening of the rental market in the months ahead, especially as we go into 2016. As mentioned at the beginning of this video, we're going to be doing our tour of the pre-construction condo market in greater downtown Miami. It'll be going on at 10 o'clock in English on December the 19th and 2 o'clock in Spanish on December the 19th. The pick-up places at our office in greater downtown Miami. If you want more information, go to cranespotters.com, CraneSpotters.com, or call us at the office, 305-865-5859. Thank you for tuning in, and be sure to check back next week for an analysis and an overview of one of the other South Florida condo markets. Thank you.